Good morning. It's time for a high five. I am dressed and ready to go because LaVon Chandler is at Praise Chapel this morning for NASA Aglow. Starts at 10 o'clock. You can still get ready and get ready to go. Yesterday, I started with some of the idioms that are found in Song of Solomon's Song of Songs. Yesterday, we really covered the first verse, which was the kiss. And that the rabbis say that means the kiss of the Torah. And Jesus is the Word. You should love the Word. You should just, you know, when I first got born again, I couldn't get enough of the Word. I just hold it to myself. And sometimes I would kiss the Bible because I loved, I would just, you know, there's a mezuzah that is on the doorpost coming into the house of a Jewish people. I have it on our doorpost. And when you walk in the door, you're supposed to wet your fingers, like kiss your fingers, and then touch the mezuzah, that you love the Word that is inside this house. And you're saying to the devil, the Word of God is inside this house. You have no right to come in. Amen. Let's talk about the, I'm on verse 4. I've skipped several verses, and I am going to skip a lot of verses because I'm not going to go verse by verse and throughout this whole thing. But it says, draw me away. It says, draw me away. Now, draw is an intimacy word. Draw is an intimacy word. Just draw me singular. Draw me. Just bring me to yourself. Just lead me. Draw me away. Away from everything that's happening. Away from distractions. And then she switches in this verse and says, we will run after you. Now, run is an idiom for ministry. We will run is plural. Now, who is she talking about? There's three absolutely main characters in the Song of Solomon. Number one is a king. Number two is a Shulamite. So we have Jesus, the bridegroom, and we have the bride of Christ. Now, the third one, who is that? That's the daughters of Jerusalem. When it talks about the daughters of Jerusalem, they're talking about people that are immature believers. They're immature believers. And, you know, they have revelation that comes from someone else. They have no intimacy with Jesus Christ himself. They draw their intimacy from someone else. Oh, did you hear what this person said? Oh, this person went to heaven. This person said this. This person said that. But what is Jesus saying to you? You know, she says, I'm going to take many people with me. I'm not going to just, you know, when you draw me, I'm going to spread the word. Everything you tell me, I'm going to spread that word to many. There's too many immature believers that need to have intimacy. And we will run after you. Running represents a life service. And you know who sets a pace? Jesus sets a pace. Sometimes he has you stop and do nothing. And sometimes he has you just run, you know, busy. The king has brought me. Now it's back into intimacy, because when the king draws you, it's in your secret chamber. He brought me into a secret chamber in his chambers. That's our secret place. He who dwells in a secret place, the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And it says, we will be glad and rejoice. See, she says, when you draw me, I'm going to draw other people to you. When you bring me into the secret place, I'm going to tell other people what you said. We will be glad and rejoice in you. We will remember your love rightly. Rightly do they love you. You know, the chambers it's talking about here, this is the bridal chamber. This is the secret place. And brought me, it actually is carried me. You carried me into the threshold. It's talking about the love relationship between Jesus and the church. And it says, we will remember. We will remember you. We will remember your love more than any distracting temptations. Purpose, we need to purpose to remember. We need to encourage ourselves. We need to reread our journals and see what Jesus has to say. Revelation 2, to the church of Ephesus, Jesus said, remember, repent, and do your first works. What were your first works? Your first works was intimacy with Jesus. When you first got born again, you weren't running all over the place. It was intimacy with Jesus. And so I leave you with that today. God bless you. I'm excited to hear what LaVon Chandler has to say. You know, she's one of my favorite prophets, and she's always 100% right of the prophecies that she's ever given me. So God bless you. Have a great day. Bye-bye.